Synth pulses are big parts in many film and game scores. They are the driving force behind action-loaded hybrid tracks and are the element that pushes them forward. But when you want to create them yourself, how do you go about that? Should you start to find a suitable preset? Or start from a blank sheet? And what synth should you even use? In this video, we're going to take a look at a simple four-step formula that I call NOOF, N-O-O-F. You can use this formula to create your own massive synth pulses in any kind of synth. In this example, we're going to use it to create the same kind of synth pulse in four different popular soft synths. When you have this formula as a part of your sound design arsenal, you will be able to create your synth pulses easier and faster than searching through tons of presets to try to find a patch that suits your track. But before that, I have a gift for you. Widgets are the most used sound effects that we have today. They are super effective as edit points both in games, movies, and TV. The problem with them is that they are really hard to create. And that's why I have created this cheat sheet for you. In the cheat sheet, you get a short overview of the different layers of a widget that you need to consider when you create them and the different sections that you need to think about. This is a totally free download. The link is in the description. Just go ahead, download it, and use it as my free gift to you. And now let's get back to create some synths. All right, so let's dive in and take a look at what the NOOF formula is all about. NOOF stands for Noise Oscillator Oscillator Filter. And it's just this simple formula invented by me. It's just the meat and potato of how I create these kinds of sounds. Because when I'm in heat of battle and I'm in and writing a track and I just want like this synth pulse, I just want to have like that quick guide into how I create the sounds. And then I can of course add more ingredients to it and sparkle things on top of it. But this is like the meat and potato. It's like the distilled guide to how I create these kinds of sounds. And when you have a formula like this, you can apply that to any kind of soft synths that you work in. And that's one more strength why you want to have that. So let's dive into Serum first and take a look at that. After Serum, we dive into Faceplant, then Pigments, and last but not least, Vital. All right, so let's follow the NOOF formula and start with the noise oscillator in Serum. I've chosen some white noise here. It sounds like this. Just a small burst of energy on top there. Not super impressive, but it will add to the sound in the end. Then we continue with the first O. This is the first oscillator, and this is just the default patch when you open up Serum. This is what comes up, and I haven't done anything to it, so it sounds like this. Just a sawtooth together with the white noise now. So the third step is the second O of the NOOF formula, is the second oscillator. And this is also the default oscillator, but I have done some tweaks to it. I pitched it up one octave. I detuned it a tiny bit against the first one. I gave it some additional voices, so five voices instead of one, and then detuning them a bit also. It will have a higher tonality and it will have a bit more width to the overall sound than if we just work with one oscillator. And then the unison and the detuning would add more life to the overall sound. So now it sounds like this. So much richer sound, but it's still not that pumping synth pulse that we're after. So let's add the last stage of the formula, the F. I have just used a ladder filter here and I have the cutoff set all the way down and I just run everything into that filter. And then I use envelope 2. This is triggered by each MIDI note. So I have some eighth notes here in the MIDI information and each time one of those place, it triggers this envelope and that envelope modulates this cutoff here. So each time it will just open up the filter a bit and then it will come down immediately depending on the settings that I have with the attack, the decay, the sustain and release over here. So all in all, it will sound like this. And now we have that synth pulse that we're striving for. But now we can't hear the noise, and we can barely hear oscillator B also. And that's the thing that you will work with the most when you're writing your track. You can automate the cutoff of the filter, and that's super powerful when you have it set up like this. If we just tweak it a little bit, and now if I remove the noise, changes the sound kind of dramatically, and if I mute oscillator B, it changes dramatically. But if I go all the way down here, it doesn't change that much. So this way you can sculpt the sound really, really easily with just one parameter over the track. Because when you open up the cutoff, you will get more of the width from the oscillator B and more of that detune feeling. And when you get all the way up, you get more of that noise burst power on top of it. So you can use this to add in energy, remove energy, and just sculpt the sound to fit your track. So this is it for the formula and what you will work with. And then you can, of course, add tons of stuff on top of this. You can use effects and everything like that. But this is like the meat and potato, the backbone of a sound like this. So let's go ahead and just check out how it works in the other synths. Okay, so next up is Faceplant. This one sounds like this. So I have automated this a little bit, and if we compare it with Serum, they have very, very similar sound to them. So this is how it looks like inside Faceplant. We have the noise, we have two oscillators, and then we have the filter, just the formula as we did it in Serum. Of course, it looks a bit different and you have to adjust the programming according to the synth that you are in, but you can easily create the same kind of sound in any of these synths. So here we have the noise, we have the sawtooth, and then we have the second sawtooth, this with some unison. And then we have the envelope modulating the cutoff. So very much the same kind of thing. So moving on to Pigments, it sounds like this. Very much the same kind as we had in Faceplant and in Serum. Inside of Pigments, it looks like this. So we have two oscillators up here, and then we have the noise here. Just some white noise, and here is the mono sawtooth, and then we have the second engine with the sawtooth with the unison and one octave above. And they are going into one filter that is modulated by this envelope down here. So the same concept again, nothing crazy at all. And last out we have Vital. This one sounds like this. Again, very much the same. As the other synths. They have slightly different characters depending on how I program them and stuff like that. And the filters differ a bit from them and stuff like that. But the meat and potato is there. It sounds very, very similar. And you can create these in any kinds of synths. So inside Vital, it looks very much as expected. We have two sawtooth oscillators and one white noise oscillator. They're all going into the filter. The second sawtooth here is one octave above the first one, with a little bit of detuning, a little bit of unison. And then we have the filter modulated by the envelope. So there we have the full NOOF formula. It's just a simple concept to create these synth pulses. And you can, of course, do them in many different ways. This is one way. But when you have this formula in your arsenal of techniques, it's so easy for you to just bring out that formula, crack open any kind of synth that you like to work in, and just create that. And then on top of that, you can add more effects and you can start to automate that cutoff really fast and just get things rolling really, really quick. And you have always your own kind of synth pulses. So that's it for this video. I really hope you enjoyed it and you got a lot of value out of it. Don't forget to download your free Woosh Hit. The link is in the description. Take care of each other and I see you in the next video.